The DaVinci Resolve Speed Editor is my new favorite video editing tool, but so much was designed with the cut page in mind that Blackmagic, they neglected to use these camera buttons that are right here for us traditional video editors that want to work in the edit page and live switch or multicam clips. Well, in 17.4, they listened to us and made the Speed Editor even more versatile by giving us that one thing that so many of us had hoped for when it launched. Edit page multicam support. It's super simple to use, and you can jump straight to this timestamp. It's on screen right over here, if that's all you're looking for. But watch the full tutorial if you want to get a grasp of multicam workflow in DaVinci Resolve. And as usual, I promise to show you something new. If you want to paint on camera angles using the sync bin and live overwrite technique that was new with the cut page when the Speed Editor came out, I should have that tutorial linked up in the description and on screen right now. But the advantage I'm going to show you today is that the video can play back continuously as you tap a key to change angles without even stopping. Traditional multicams are nested compound clips that let you get in the groove. So here's how it all works. Here in DaVinci Resolve 17.4, I'm gonna show you how to sync up these individual clips. We've got a wide shot, a tight shot, and we're gonna combine them into one single multicam clip. To do that, you can click and drag with your mouse over both of them, right click on one of them, and go up to the very top. It says create new multicam clip using selected clips. Choose that guy, and then under multicam clip name, let's change this to something like Speed Editor Demo. And then we've got angle sync. So there's a few things I wanna change in here. By default, it says endpoint and outpoint. That's self-explanatory what those are. There's time code, which is metadata that could have been written into the file. Well, we don't on this. That would be a luxury. And I've got a tutorial on using Tentacle Sync Ease if that's something you're interested in. There's sound, which basically matches up waveforms. I know in this instance, it's not going to work good because it was windy outside, but that's like pluralize if you've used pluralize before. What I'm going to show you is how to use markers today. I've got a foolproof way on doing this with interviews with markers. Now, we're going to also change our angle name from sequential to the metadata from the camera. And check the box for detect clips from the same camera. What this is gonna make sure is that everything that you have from the same camera angle, from the same camera, is gonna end up on the same track so that you don't end up with a super tall timeline. That gets super annoying that you have to manage later. And we're gonna detect using the metadata from the camera number. Now, we don't have camera number metadata or markers on our clips in order to use those fields. So here's how you set that up, even if you don't have a slate or hand clap. Now, to see a little bit more, instead of being in the thumbnail view, we're going to change to metadata view, which is this button right here. Just gives us a little bit more to look at. I'm going to select a clip to change the metadata. I'm going to go to the upper right section. There's the metadata button or field, and we're kind of cramped. We don't have enough room, so I'm going to choose this button. It expands it out for us, gives us more room to see, but we don't have camera number available. That's because we need to change the list of options to be shot and seen. If you scroll down here, now we can see camera number. All we need to do is click into there, tap one, return, and you can see that updated over there and change that to be camera number one. We need to do the same thing over here, so we have camera number two on this clip. Just select it. That's already ready to go. We hit two. We have camera one, camera two. Now what we need to do is we need to sync these up with a common sync point, and we don't have a hand clap. We don't have a slate, but what we do have her saying is a word that sounds like a B or a P. She says the word born. So anytime someone says B or P, their mouth opens and there's a consonant that comes out. So let's take a look by double clicking this guy, and we're gonna drop a marker when her mouth opens and she says the word born. So that's a B sound.
I was born in Minnesota.
Okay, she was born in Minnesota. We're gonna look for when the word B opens her mouth, and we start to see that happen. So I'm gonna scroll back with the J key. Okay, there it is. I was born. You can see we're a little bit past when our lips open. So I'm gonna select up here. I'm gonna choose the left arrows. Okay, born. I was born. That's what we're looking for. So her lips open right there. We're tapping M on the keyboard. If you have the speed editor, you can double tap the audio level. That'll do the same thing. And then we can go to the close-up angle and find the same thing. We're looking for I was born. Okay, so I need to select up here. I had it down at the bottom. Born, I was born there. Her mouth starts to open. We're gonna hit M on the keyboard. And basically, we have a sync point between these two. We didn't even need a slate or a hand clap. Now, all we need to do to sync these and make a multicam clip is, like I showed you before, we're gonna select them both with our mouse, click and drag, right click, say, create new multicam clip using selected clips. And I think I had too much coffee. I'm talking so fast. But anyways, we're just call this, why don't we call this one born? And all the rest of this is pretty much set up to how we had done before. Angle sync is marker, right? Angle name is the metadata. We've got detect clips from the same camera, and we're using the camera numbers that we had just assigned, which is perfect. I also like to uncheck move source clips to original bin so I can organize things myself. I'll hit create, and we have a multicam clip. If I double click it, you can see everything's in sync. It's ready to rock and roll, but it's just a clip, but we don't have a timeline with it yet. The fastest way to make a timeline of it is if you right-click a clip, you can actually say create new timeline using selected clips. It makes it with all the perfect magic settings for you. And this one, why don't we call this one Speed Editor Demo, and we'll get to that next. Now double-click your new timeline with that Multicam clip to open it on the edit page. Now we're here in the edit page. If you just have a single viewer open and just one window, the way you change that to be dual viewer is this button right here, okay? So what this does is it gives you a source side and a record side. But for Multicam, you need to change this from the default right over here, this little drop down, and change this to Multicam. So as you choose Multicam, now basically you're able to use the cam buttons on your speed editor or the number pads to change angles on the fly as you're playing back. Now, the other thing I want to point out is in the lower right, this is set to default, but you can change how many camera angles you actually see in this window, in the Multicam window. So 4x4 would be 4x4, 16 camera angles at once. That's incredible. We just have two for this instance, so we'll change this back to default. And the other thing I want you to know is you can change this with a keyboard shortcut from source to Multicam. I have mine set to Command-Shift-M, and that jumps us straight over to there without having to need to go to this drop-down menu. It makes things work a little bit faster. And the way you can set that up is if you go up to the DaVinci Resolve keyboard customization and start typing in Multicam into here, and you see source viewer options. That's where you can set that up. That's not set by default, but that's what I like to do so I can work a little bit faster. Dealing with multi-channel audio in Multicam clips is one of the most confusing things ever in DaVinci Resolve, so pay close attention to this chapter. I'm gonna go fast. The challenge with multi-camera audio in DaVinci Resolve 17 is it creates adaptive audio tracks. See this over here, it says adaptive too. Basically it has mixed down everything for us. And to see that a little bit better, I'm gonna right click on the track and say open in timeline. This lets you see the inside guts of the multi-camera clip. If you ever needed to change something, that's in there. But you can also see over here, we have camera number one has a four next to it for adaptive four. Same thing with camera two. And the reason for this is I shot with a Canon C200 that has four channels of audio, but I can't edit any of these independently, and that's my problem. So if I double click this, that'll get us out of the open in timeline, and I go back to the media page. You can see here on clip one and two is what I want, three and four are garbage, I wanna delete those. And camera two, that's all scratch. I don't need to hear any of that sound. So if I go back to the edit page, let me show you how you get access to just the channels that you want. In this case, I just want access to channels one and two. So in the edit page, first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna choose the audio down here that we wanna be working with. And it's set to camera two right now, and I want camera one. So to do that, you go over here, you choose multi-camera, we're gonna choose audio only. And to change it, you just hold option on the keyboard and then click the camera angle that you want. So because it's audio only, that just switched it over there for us. Awesome, right? So at least we have that going for us. Now the next thing we need to do is need to break this out of multi-camera. That's the problem, is the multi-camera. So to get it out of multi-camera and we still have access to the multi-camera video, all you need to do is hold option on the keyboard. That decouples those, so we're just selecting the audio only, which is what we're dealing with. You right-click and you say flatten multicam clip. By doing that, you have just pulled the audio only part out of multicam. So you can see this is the original clip name. And if you think we're not going anywhere, we just have one audio track here, you're wrong. And I can show you that because you can right-click and say display individual audio channels. And just like that, we can see all four tracks originally from that we saw on the media page. But we just want access to one and two, and we still can't edit them independently. Here's the next steps you gotta do. So we flattened it, we displayed audio channels just to show you, and now we need to change the track type over here from adaptive two to adaptive four, obviously, because there's four channels. And now, basically, what that has done is it's given us the opportunity to break this apart properly. So we're gonna right click in this track header area and say convert to linked group. What that did is it sort of broke things out, but they're linked together, they're tied together. We still have just one fader over here in the track header area. So to get access to these separately is we break apart the linked group. Now that we created a linked group, and you do that by going up to the Fairlight menu at the top, okay? And then you say link group, and then you select this right here, because they're all linked together, and you say unlink, and that's it. That's the magic to all of it. So now we have four different channels over here in the mixer, four different tracks to work with. And we have access to channels one and two, which had our good lav, you know, our good sound on it, and three and four, which is the garbage, but now we can just option select them, delete them, and you'll be able to edit to your heart's content. And a quick safety thing you might want to do is select the clips and right click and say link clips. That gives you that little chain link icon over there. That way, in case you move something by accident, you get the out-of-frame sync indicators.
Hey, I'm hoping that last chapter was worth the price of admission to this tutorial, and I've earned the opportunity to welcome you here to this channel. I'm Chadwick, and this is Creative Video Tips. It's all about helping you craft videos that make a difference and stand out. So if you're into that, subscribe right now, maybe with a bell too, so you don't miss out on future Resolve tutorials. It really helps our small channel out a lot, so I'd super appreciate it. Now let's take a look at the new Speed Editor functionality.
We got the speed editor out, we're having fun. All you need to do is make sure you go over here and make sure you turn on multi-camera. That way these buttons are gonna work. So push play, and you can tap the button that you wanna change the camera angle to. So I'm gonna push play.
I was born in Minnesota.
Now I'm gonna change it to camera angle two.
At the age of four.
And it cuts straight to angle two while it's playing back. That's the magic of this.
Outdoors with my family.
Camera one.
At the age of 14, I was able
camera
to
two.
Go on my first hunt.
Okay, and then if you want to change an angle later on, that's the other thing that they added on here. If I scroll back here with the search style and I want this to be camera two instead and I made a mistake, you could just double tap it and it changes the angle. Or I could double tap back and it goes to the other angle. Or you could use undo. There's lots of stuff you can do. Obviously, other things on here work too, like you can hit the roll button, hold that down, and change the point and when things change. Now, you don't have to have the speed editor. I just want to show you how that works on here. If you want to use the keyboard, the traditional keyboard, this thing over here, you can use this number pad section as well. 1, 2 on here, all the way up to 9. They work the same as these buttons do. So you tap them once, they cut. And if you want to change the angle, you hold option and push that button.
Hey, suppose you have trouble with choppy playback from lots of 4K and 8K footage. In that case, I suggest watching this tutorial on using proxies, or if you want to unlock all the potential of the speed editor, check out this playlist full of pro tips. And because there's so much more to learn, I'll see you in the next video. Oh, and hit that like button before it's too late.